Salt Lake City up, Fenho Houston's offense gets going. The Rockets are nearly impossible to beat. James Harden had 25 points and 12 assists to lead Houston to a 113-92 win over Utah in Game 3 of the Western Conference Semifinals Series on Friday. Nicht. Eric Gordon added 25 points and Chris Paul had 15 points, 7 rebounds and 6 assists for the Rockets. Houston beat Utah in Salt Lake City for the third time this season to take a 2-1 series lead. Game 4 is on Sunday. The Rockets attacked the Jazz very fairly and wrote to rolling up 70 points before halftime. When Utah drove Houston off the perimeter, it yielded three paths and slashes to the rim for layups. When the Jazz dropped back into shore up the interior, the Rockets came up with ultimate 3-pointers to keep the heat on. "We're just not going to force anything," Harden said. "Whatever they give us, we're going to take and we're going to have confidence in our guys and we're going to make shots." Royson Hales scored 17 points. Alex Burks hipped in 14 points w Hill. Rudy Gobert added 12 points and 9 rebounds for the Jazz. Utah never got on track on offense. The Jazz shot poorly over the first three quarters and committed 16 turnovers. Houston scored 19 points off the semis twice. "It took to our defense was superb," Rockets coach Mike D'Antoni said. "We were hitting shots all over the place. We just got a hold of it, kept the throat out of it and kept them on their heels. You could see the guys feeding off good defense after good defense. When you dot hot and your energy is rigged, the shots start to go down and good things happen. Houston could not have scripted a much better start than had the Rockets produced on Friday night. A listless first half effort ultimately sealed Houston's fate in Game 2. The Rockets avoided enduring an otters love start by slamping down on defense and playing efficient offense. Houston picked apart Utah's defense practically from the opening tip. The Rockets opened the game by scoring baskets on 6 of their first 7 possessions. Harden tapped the floor with his first basket to put Houston up 15-5. It only grew worse for the Jazz from there. The Rockets led by as many as 22 in the first quarter, taking a 37-15 lead on back-to-back baskets from Harden and Gerald Green. Houston made 16 of its 26 shots in the first quarter and totaled 39 points in the period. "They were focused and determined to do what they wanted to do," Jazz coach Quinn Snyder said. "We just didn't provide enough resistance in a lot of areas. As effective as the Rockets were on offense, their defense proved equally troublesome for Utah." Houston forced the Jazz to commit 6 turnovers before the start of the second quarter and scored 9 points off those turnovers. "They just took us out of our hitman dwets and let that happen," guard Donovan Mitchell said. "They were the aggressor all night and we got to be able to understand they're gonna be aggressive and we got to be able to counter." Utah cut Houston's lead 49-34 midway through the second quarter after on Hales scored three strike baskets to fuel a 9-0 run. Clint Capela ended the run with a dunk and the Rockets proceeded to outscore the Jazz 31-9 over a 10-minute stretch extending into the third quarter. They pushed their lead to 80-43 on a driving layup from Ariza with 801 left in the quarter. Tippins Rockets Gordon finished with a post-season high in points. Houston did not commit a turnover in the first quarter. The Rockets outscored the Jazz 20-10 in fast break points after totaling just 5 in Game 2. Houston finished with 50 points in the paint for the second straight game. Jazz Derrick Favors exited with an ankle sprain in the third quarter. Favors totaled 2 points, 2 rebounds and 2 assists in 13 minutes. Houston's 39 first quarter points is the most given up by Utah in any quarter in a playoff game at his season. Mitchell's scored on 10 points after going used 4 of 16 from the field. Back to former Rick Gordon got his shot in Grove Batsking game 3. Gordon attacked the rim early and then hit several K3-pointers as the game progressed. He ended up going 8 of 13 from the field and shooting 50% from the 3-point line. It marked a big hang of pace for Gordon who has struggled to find his shot at times during the postseason. Coming into Friday night, he had shot just 31.4% from the field and averaged 12.9 points over 7 playoff games just got to continue to be aggressive, Gordon said. It doesn't hang for me.